Leader's questions, Colin Deputy Micheál.
Thank you, Ciarán Cóirle. Tánaiste, parents and people across the country are still reacting to the primetime programme's expose of behaviour in creches, of cruelty to children, of emotional abuse that was witnessed in the film footage during the primetime programme. And I think many people are looking really for immediate responses as well as medium-term and short-term responses. I think the situation has clearly shocked many people across the country. And what I would like to put to you this morning is some immediate steps that could be taken to respond to the issues that have been raised and to enhance the service that is currently in place, and particularly the inspection regime. I mentioned yesterday, Tánaiste, to the Taoiseach, that there were five areas that had no inspectors at all for the last while: Dublin South City, Sligo, Leitrim, Louth, Cavan and North Monaghan. I would ask you if you could confirm or indicate a specific timeline for the filling of vacancies in those special in those particular areas where we have no inspectors at the moment to carry out any inspections of childcare facilities, which I'm sure you'll agree is absolutely unacceptable, and will you confirm that they will be filled immediately and a timeline outlined? In relation to the creches that have been the subject of the RTE Primetime Investigates programme, will funding be cut from those creches given the serious breaches of regulations that have been uncovered? And do you find it acceptable, Tánaiste, that the creches concerned, and in particular the creches under investigation by the Gardaí, should remain open presently whilst under investigation? Or should their activities be suspended pending the outcome of such investigations, or alternatively significant additional safeguards put in to protect children in those particular creches?
Thank you.
Would you agree that CCTV cameras should be introduced immediately in all creches? Currently, 2 out of 3 have CCTV in place. In relation to the 50,000 children who are minded in their homes by private childminders, Tánaiste, can you confirm, because the original heads of bill in relation to Children First did not include the thousands of children, under, you know, and it could be under number 4, are not provided for either training, licensing, or any inspection regime whatsoever? Will they be included in Children First? And specifically on the legislation, Tánaiste, and this is a key issue, because I haven't really received specific confirmation in terms of the timeline around Children First. When can we expect that bill? My understanding is the heads were published some time, but it's gone back to the drawing board. And in terms of the children and the Child and Family Support Agency, again, we have no clear timeline as to when the legislation is going to be published and enacted. And by any, if you look at it objectively, Tánaiste, it looks like that agency will not be established until well into 2014, if you look at the timeline now that is being suggested for the legislation. So I think we need urgent clarification on the legislative area, particularly in Children First and the Child and Family
Thank
Support
you.
Agency.
Tánaiste.
Well, I agree with Deputy Martin that what was shown in the primetime programme was shocking. It was hard to watch. It is completely unacceptable. It's every parent's worst nightmare that the childcare facility in which they entrust their children may not be treating those children appropriately. I think it has to be said also that there are a lot of very good childcare services and facilities in this country who are operating well. But some of the operators have clearly let the children down, have let their parents down, and particularly so in circumstances where parents are paying a hell of a lot of money to these facilities to mind their children. I spoke with Minister Fitzgerald this morning, and we are agreed that this is an issue that has to be addressed with urgency, and we are determined that this issue will be resolved. In the first instance, the creche facilities, which were the subject of the television programme, are the subject of a HSE investigation and a Garda investigation. There are a number of things that need to be done and will be done quickly. First of all, there will be a facility whereby the inspection reports which are made on childcare facilities will be published online so that parents can see themselves the report on the childcare facility itself. Secondly, you asked about the areas where there aren't inspectors at the moment. The intention is that the inspection regime will be managed on a national basis, and the Minister has asked Gordon Jays to look at the ways in which that can be done so that all areas of the country are being properly inspected. There will be a system of registration that will be introduced to replace the existing system of notification. That will be done by the Child and Family Agency. The intention is that that system will be in place within a reasonably short period of time. There will be a report done on the for-profit childcare sector, an analysis done of all of the inspection reports that have been presented to date to establish what patterns there are and what needs to be done. The question of qualifications for childcare workers, that is being looked at. I think it is the Minister's view that FITAC level 5 is probably too low and that that needs to be increased. I appreciate the suggestions that you have made, Deputy Martin, and I know that you have said that this is an issue that we need to resolve and to work together on to resolve. On the issue of the inspection regime, that is being addressed immediately to ensure that there is an inspection regime right across the country. In the case of creches which are not complying with the standards that are required, yes, the funding can be cut, and I believe should be cut to those creches. The issue of the creches, which are the subject of investigation, I would hope that those investigations will be concluded quickly, and whatever action then needs to be taken is taken as a result. I agree that CCTV cameras should be in use in creche facilities, and in respect of the currently the wider area of childcare provision. As I said, that is something that will be dealt with under the registration regime that will be brought in.
To Conor, for your reply, I'm still not clear on the legislation timelines. The heads of bill for the Child and Family Support Agency were approved by Cabinet last November. Lisa Taoiseach indicated that in the order of business to our spokesman, Robert Troy, that last November they would have been agreed. It's now June. I'm not clear, will it be published before the end of July? It might be useful to consider an all-party committee to look at that bill and the Children First Bill in order to accelerate and also to tease out the issues that may be holding up the publication of the bill. Are there fundamental issues that are at issue here? I don't know. But I'm not getting any clear timeline in terms of either the Children First legislation or the Child and Family Support legislation and the publication of that. I referenced the 50,000 children who were being minded privately in homes across the country because they weren't covered, apparently, by the initial heads of the Children First Bill. And there are issues clearly pertaining to that sector as well, given what we've now witnessed in the breach of trust that's been exposed in these particular creches. The issue of when Garda investigations take place, I think, is a very serious one. And in other areas, and I know, to be fair, we're not dealing with the other areas of abuse that we've experienced in other institutions in the past, or when allegations were made about individuals. But whenever the Gardaí were introduced in a formal investigative process, people have been suspended for any interaction with children while such investigations are underway. And it would seem to me that there are issues here in terms of the questions under investigation. Either they should not remain open while the investigations are underway, or additional interventions by the HSE and others should happen.
Thank you.
To remove any doubt whatsoever that the children in those specific crèches are vulnerable to any sort of emotional abuse or cruelty or whatever. And I think, obviously, the response has to be very robust and has to send a very clear message that the kind of behaviour uncovered is absolutely unacceptable to everybody and has consequences. And I think that in itself would help immediately send a wake-up call to every facility, and there's many good facilities, I acknowledge what you're saying. But a clear message has to emerge in terms of the response to what has been uncovered to signify a watershed in terms of how these kind of unacceptable activities are dealt with.
Honestly.
Well, I agree with that absolutely. I think that what was shown in the television programme does require immediate action and an absolute determination to deal with what is clearly, absolutely unacceptable. Parents leaving their children in a childcare facility need to know, at a minimum, that their child is safe, is not going to be mistreated, and need to know that we have a regime in place and that there is a determination to make sure that there is a regime in place that ensures that that happens. On the legislation, the plan is that the legislation will be published this session, both pieces of legislation. There were some policy issues that came up in the Oireachtas Committee earlier that were being considered. I agree with you that I think it is something that could be considered at an early stage by the Oireachtas Committee. I know that the Health Committee is due to meet on the 11th of June and that it is their intention to bring in the HSE and to conduct meetings on what actually happened and the issues that arise from that programme, and I think a way can be found whereby they can address the heads of the legislation. The legislation is intended to be published this session in any event, so we'll move with that. The Garda investigation, that obviously has to take its course, but our determination, and again, as I said, I spoke with Minister Fitzgerald this morning, our determination is that the investigations will be done quickly, that there will be firm response to the outcome of those investigations. The issue of the continued funding of childcare facilities, which are found wanting, that funding can be cut, and there is a determination to ensure that we're not applying taxpayers' money to facilities that are not operating properly.
Thank you.
I think we need to be absolutely clear on this, that what was shown on the television programme is utterly unacceptable. It's unacceptable to Minister Fitzgerald, it's unacceptable to me, it's unacceptable to the government, and it is something that we will deal with and deal with quickly.
Thank you.